Firstly, thank you so much for commenting and reminding me about today's topic. Honestly, I had completely forgotten about Python input function. Anyways, what's up internet, I am Manish from rebellionwriter.com. Today's tutorial is all about Python input function. In this tutorial, we will learn how to take user input in Python programming, what are the shortcomings of Python input function, and how to overcome them. So without wasting much of your time, let's start. But before that, if you are new to my channel, then please consider subscribing, as this year I'm aiming for 100,000 subscribers. Also, if you enjoy watching, then please hit that thumbs up button. Now, let's start. In Python programming, in order to take input from users, we use an inbuilt function called input. Earlier in Python 2, this function was known by the name of raw_input, which was later changed with a much simpler name, input, in Python 3. raw_input function is obsolete in Python 3, which means if you are using the latest version of Python, then you will not be able to use it. Anyways, here is the syntax of the Python print function. Just by looking at the syntax, we can tell that the function call is pretty simple. The function takes only one argument, which is prompt. This could be any text which prompts the user for input. Usually, it's almost always a string. For example, enter your first name. Also, this only argument of Python input function is optional, which means if you want, you can skip it. Now, let's write an example of Python print function. Also, let's see what problem does this function cause. Here we have our input function call. The string enter your first name is the prompt. On execution, the Python interpreter will show this prompt string on the screen to the user and will wait for the user to type the input and press the enter key. Here we are just taking the input, but we are not storing that input anywhere in the memory, thus we cannot use it. Therefore, I will create a variable which will hold the value of this input. So I created the variable f_name and assigned the input value to it. Now on execution, the Python interpreter will show you the prompt enter your first name and wait for you to enter some data and press the enter key. As soon as you press the enter key, the interpreter will take the value which you have entered and store it into the variable f_name. Here we have one more statement which will print the value stored into the variable f_name with the string welcome. Now let's execute and see the result. Here is our Python prompt. Great. Today I am using a new plugin for executing our Python program, as the previous one was not very suitable for such dynamic Python programming. Anyways, see, the interpreter has showed you the prompt and is now waiting for you to enter some value. Let's give it some value to store. Let's say Manish. After all, it's my first name. Now let's hit enter key and see what happens. Welcome Manish, which means we have taken and processed the user input successfully. That's how we take user input in Python. The tutorial isn't over yet. Now we will discuss the shortcomings of Python input function. The only problem with the input function of Python library is that it returns a string. Yes, the input function takes the data from the user and converts it into a string. Now you ask, Manish, what is the problem with that? Yes, there is no problem with that, as long as you want the user to input a string. But if you want to accept an integer or float value, then there is a problem. Let's do an example and try to understand. Let's see, instead of username, you want the user to enter the salary and then you want to give that user a bonus of 1000 on his salary. Let's write a program for that. The code is looking perfectly fine. Because it is. Now let's execute and see the result. What? We got an error. The code was perfect. Then why did we got the error? It was because we tried to perform an arithmetic operation between a string and an integer value. The salary 10,000 may look like an integer, but it is not. Because before storing that value into the variable salary, the input function converted it into a string. You can check the data type of any variable in Python using another inbuilt function called type. The type function of the Python library returns the type of the object you are calling this function for. Let me show you the type of our variable salary. For that, we first need to comment the last two statements to avoid the errors. Done. Now we will write another print statement into which we will call the type function. Here, inside the print statement, we called the type function, and as a parameter for that, we write the name of our variable salary whose data type we want to find out. Let's check the output. As you can see that the variable salary belongs to the class string. That means the data type of the variable salary is a string. And in Python programming, we cannot perform arithmetic operation between a string and an integer value. Now, let's talk about the solution. But first, let's close this output panel. Done. The best solution of this problem is to typecast the variable salary from a string to integer. That's very easy. Let me show you. To convert the data type of the variable salary into an integer, we will use another built-in function called int. First, let's undo all the changes and get back to our initial code. Done. Here is our arithmetic expression where we are adding 1000 into the salary. This same expression is also causing the error because the data type of value which is stored into the variable salary is a string and we are trying to add an integer to it, which is not a legitimate call in Python programming. So what we are going to do here is that we will convert the data type of the data stored into the salary variable from a string to integer. Let's do that. Here in this expression, I deleted the variable and in its place, I called the built-in function int. Now as a parameter of this function, I will specify the name of the variable whose value we want to typecast, which in our case is salary. That's all we have to do. Now let's execute and see if we still have the error or get the output. No error this time, and we got the desired output. Now you ask, what if I want to take an integer input from the user? See, except from converting the data type of the inputted value from a string to integer, there is no other way to accept the integer input from the user. Input function will always convert the inputted value into the string, no matter what. But we are programmers, and we can always find out the solution. So, what can we do? See, in the solution which I just demonstrated to you, we converted the data type of the inputted data after it was stored into the variable salary. We can do this conversion before the inputted value gets stored into the variable. Let me show you how you can do that. In order to typecast the data before it gets stored into the variable, we have to place the entire input function call inside the int function. Yes, you heard it right. We have to pass this input function call as the parameter of the int function. Let's do that. Let's first close this output prompt and clear the worksheet and write a fresh code. Here I call the int function. Now inside the parentheses, we will call the input function. Now, we will store this entire contraption of nested function calls into a variable. Let's name that variable age. This weird looking contraption of nested function call will convert the data type of the value entered by the user from string to integer before it gets saved into the variable. You want to check? Let's do that. Here I call the type function. This function will show us the data type of the variable age. Let's say 28. As you can see here, this time the variable into which we stored the user input belongs to an integer class rather than a string, which means the data type of the variable age is integer. Now I want you to do one thing. I will leave this code in the description. You just have to copy the code and execute it. But in the place of any integer, I want you to enter a string or a float value and comment the output you get. So in this tutorial, we learned how to take a user input using Python input function. We also learned how to take an integer input in Python along with some added benefits like how to use type function to find out the data type of the variable and how to typecast a variable from a string to integer using int function. I guess we have covered a lot of topics today. So I think it's time to wind up this tutorial here. But if you want to learn how to take a float value as input in Python, then check out the corresponding blog. You can also get all the codes which I demonstrated to you in today's video from that same blog. Link is in the description. That's it for today. If you like the video, then give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Also, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.